We're here at the Traders Expo. My guest is Linda Rashke. We're talking about market profile and what the most valuable concepts there are. So, Linda, talk about market profile. What are the most valuable concepts you know of there?
I think it's an excellent tool to lend conceptual framework to the markets. I really feel that too many newer traders get hung up on 5-minute bar charts and oscillators. And of course, these things are valuable because they're going to give you overall, you know, bias if there's an upswing or a downswing and so forth. But if you study market profile theory, that's really the true basis of auction theory, which goes to the heart of the price discovery process. And of course, you know, every, you know, different methodology has its own semantics or terminology. So you can find similar things, but a market profile, it takes away the time element and it consolidates the action so that you can see where was the levels that the price traded most about. So you have a central value area. And you know, several key concepts can come out of that. If you push away from a value area, then you can come to a stronger trending environment. Of course, with traditional technical analysis, you would want to see volume confirm that. So you're either pushing out away from one of those value areas, or if the price hits an area where there's price rejection, no volume, it's probably going to gravitate back towards that central value area. So it's a different feeling aside from the time concepts and so forth of moving away outside of a value area or retracing back into it. And also I think that something that's useful for people to think about are price rejection spikes. When the market's testing in the auction process, and in other words, auctioning down, looking for buyers or so forth, you can have these price rejection spikes. So if you keep in the context that the market tested and rejected a certain area, perhaps you're less likely to get caught up in buying that first retracement, thinking that there's a bull flag on a 5-minute chart or something like that. So it gives you a different way to visualize the price action, and I think that's a great value to people.
All right, so is this available on most software trading platforms?
It is. And I have to say, honestly, the people that use it either really latch onto it and identify with it. It's not something that you have to use, but I just think that the concepts that it lends to our field of technical analysis or just study of the price behavior are very important because they're free of that time denominator in the same way, just like point and figure charts are. They're going to give you a different type of representation of the overall price action. Obviously, point and figure is something that's not used so much anymore, but the concepts that you've consolidated for a long time, there's the old saying, the longer the base, the higher up into space, the broader the top, the greater the drop, and the point and figure charts are a way of indicating that. So I just think it opens people's minds up to a different type of conceptual framework, which is really important. Then when the day is unfolding, there's some wonderful concepts of people by Jim Dalton's book, Mind Over Markets. There's some good chapters in there that describe the price action around the opening. So for example, just like in our previous interview when we were talking about technical analysis, but yet the market gaps up and a whole different game plan could unfold, thinking about that, is there a strong drive off of the opening price? Okay, so you see this is free of bar charts and free of oscillators and so forth. Now we're looking at how does the price behave off of the opening. Is there an open drive, in which case it never trades below the opening price, but has a very strong initial 30-minute bar up? If you see that, that's probably the presence of what we call the proverbial higher time frame players, and that can lead to a much stronger, trendier type of day. However, if, for example, you have open auction, which is open, rotate, fluctuate on both sides of the opening price, if there's light volume, the market's probably going to stay in a relatively contained range all day. So for me as a trader, that's going to set the tone that I might be more aggressive in making counter trend trades. And which is really important if you're a trader, you don't want to think about making counter trend trades on a trend day, and likewise, you don't want to be trading continuation patterns if you're just fluctuating in a light volume range. So I think it's really important for putting things in a context.
Linda, thanks for your time.
Thank you, Tim.
You're watching the MoneyShow.com video network.